In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Welcome to this Eucharist. It's a great privilege to be celebrating with you. My name is Jane. I'm one of the archdeacons in the Diocese of Southwark. So wherever you are in the diocese, or indeed in the world, you're very, very welcome. And let us give thanks to God for the technology that enables us to pray and praise together in these very unusual times. We begin by praying that God may prepare our hearts for worship. If you have the words of the service in front of you, please do join in wherever you are. And so let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, Jesus Christ, to save us from our sins, to be our advocate in heaven, and to bring us to eternal life. So let us confess our sins in penitence and faith, firmly resolved to keep God's commandments and to live in love and peace. Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, we have sinned against you and against our neighbour, in thought and word and deed, through negligence, through weakness, through our own deliberate fault. We are truly sorry, and repent of all our sins, for the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, who died for us. Forgive us all that is past, and grant that we may serve you in newness of life, to the glory of your name. Amen. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and keep you in life eternal, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. The collect for this, the 11th Sunday after Trinity. O God, you declare your almighty power, most chiefly in showing mercy and pity. Mercifully grant to us such a measure of your grace that we, running the way of your commandments, may receive your gracious promises and be made partakers of your heavenly treasure. Through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Amen.
Our first reading is from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. This is a strictly spatially distanced Eucharist, and only members of my household are present, and so we now hear the reading.
A reading from Paul's letter to the Romans, chapter 12. I appeal to you, therefore, brothers and sisters, by the mercies of God, to present your bodies as a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable to God, which is your spiritual worship. Do not be conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your minds, so that you may discern what is the will of God, what is good, acceptable, and perfect. For by grace given to me, I say to every one among you, not to think of yourself more highly than you ought to think, but to think with sober judgment, each according to the measure of faith that God has assigned. For as in one body, we have many members, and not all the members have the same function. So we, who are many, are one body in Christ, and individually we are members of one another. We have gifts that differ according to the grace given to us. Prophecy, in proportion to faith. Ministry, in ministering. The teacher, in teaching. The exhorter, in exhortation. The giver, in generosity. The leader, in diligence. The compassionate, in cheerfulness. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Whether you are at home with others or whether you are on your own, if you are able, you may wish to stand now for the gospel. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now when Jesus came into the district of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, "Who do people say that the Son of Man is?" And they said, "Some say John the Baptist, but others Elijah, and still others Jeremiah or one of the prophets." He said to them, "But who do you say that I am?" Simon Peter answered, "You are the Messiah, the Son of the living God." And Jesus answered him, "Blessed are you, Simon, son of Jonah. For flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father in heaven. And I tell you, you are Peter, and on this rock I will build my church, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. I will give you the keys of the kingdom of heaven, and whatever you bind on earth will be bound in heaven, and whatever you loose on earth will be loosed in heaven." Then he sternly ordered the disciples not to tell anyone that he was the Messiah. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
So as we gather on one of the church's holy days, a Sunday, the day in which we particularly remember the resurrection of our Lord, let us proclaim together our faith. We believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate from the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy, Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. So now we come to a time of intercession. There may be particular people or places for whom you would like to intercede. And I will try and leave space for you to do that. So, in the power of the Spirit and in union with Christ, let us pray to the Father. For the peace of the whole world, for the welfare of the Holy Church of God wherever she is found, and especially for Justin, our Archbishop, and Christopher, our Bishop. For the unity of all people, Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For the parishes in which we usually worship, the churches from which we come, for all those preparing for ordination this coming Michaelmas, for the work of the church during this pandemic, especially among the poor and hardest hit. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who travel, those who have to travel to work, to minister to others, to bring care and comfort or emergency care to others. For those who would like to travel but are unable to do so, to see relatives and friends for rest and recreation. For all those whose livelihoods are involved with travel and who are anxious about their future and their families, Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
For those who suffer, for those who are afraid, especially those who are afraid of the impact of coronavirus on their well-being, physical, mental, spiritual, or other. For those who are sick in our hospitals, care homes, those who are sick alone. For our doctors, nurses, chaplains, and others who care for them. For our hospital porters, receptionists, telephone operators, technicians, and the hundreds of thousands of hidden staff who in work to clear our streets and our dustbins, keep our offices and hospitals running, contribute to our well-being. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
For those who taught us the way of faith, those without whom we would not know the Lord Jesus, and for the people who come within our sphere, that we too may pass on the faith. Lord, hear us.
Lord, graciously hear us.
In a moment of quiet, let us offer our own private prayers and petitions to our Heavenly Father. And now we say together, Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ is the Prince and the Bringer of Peace. At this time of difficulty, let us be so grateful for his peace within our hearts, and let us always live out of that divine peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
I'm going to lay the altar now for communion. During that time, I want to invite you to consider this as a sacred space for potential giving. I'm sure you give to your own church, wherever it is, but if you have particular reason or are particularly able to give to the Diocese of Southwark, we'd be very, very grateful. We have a Vision Development Fund, which is to help resource new mission in our churches, and particularly at this time, all kinds of new mission opportunities and need are opening up. So we'll put the details of the BACS, the bank account, but also give.net if you would like to do that. But if you don't, that's just perfectly fine, and please compose yourself to receive communion. But thank you. Be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh. As your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin, He lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. So he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and saying, Holy, 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 holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Lord, you are holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant that, by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your holy will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we bring before you this bread and this cup, we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of Mary, the mother of Jesus, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever. Amen. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Jesus, Lamb of God, have mercy on us. Jesus, bearer of our sins, have mercy on us. Jesus, Redeemer of the world, grant us peace. Jesus is the Lamb of God, who takes away the sin of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. The body of Christ. The blood of Christ. So now we have consecrated these elements. I invite you to take a moment of silence to make your spirit your communion, that the benefits of our Lord's sacrifice may be available to us all. Let us pray. Lord of all mercy, we, your faithful people, have celebrated that one true sacrifice which takes away our sin and brings pardon and peace. By our communion, keep us firm on the foundation of the gospel and preserve us from all sin through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. So let us pray together. Father of all, we give you thanks and praise that when we were still far off, you met us in your Son and brought us home. Dying and living, he declared your love, gave us grace and opened the gate of glory. May we who share Christ's body live his risen life. We who drink his cup bring life to others. We, whom the Spirit lights, give light to the world. Keep us firm in the hope you have set before us, so we and all your children shall be free, and the whole earth live to praise your name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be among you and remain with you always. Amen. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ.
Amen. Amen. Once again, thank you for joining this service. We'll hold the giving details up again if you wish to support the future of the Diocese of Southwark. And may the Lord be with you this coming week.